This is an ad for a project management tool called Monday.com. This is what it looks like, and this is what it feels like.
For so many 3D artists, anime fans, and also manga fans, creating your own 3D digital customized anime character would be a dream come true, especially if you have an app that would allow you to create this stuff, use it for whatever thing you want to do, pose it the way you want, give you all of the dynamics that you would want to make use of, style it the way you want it to be, and at the end of the day, export it and use it to any platform you want. Hi guys, and welcome to Ask NK. In today's video, we're going to be talking about an app called Vroid Studio. And the Vroid Studio is actually made by about, I think, two Japanese guys. One's name is Shingpon and I think Nario. I'm sorry if I muttered the name, but that's what it is. And how this app works is pretty simple. All it does for you is gives you the ability to create your own digital anime avatar. So, for example, you like to play with anime avatars, you love animes, but you want to create yours, this app would actually help you create yours. If you want to understand how you can get this out of here and maybe take it over to Maya or Blender and use it for your own 3D project, just sit right in while I explain. So for you to be able to get this app, or for you to be able to download this, you have to definitely go over to the website, which is www.studio.vroid.com. And when you go over here, funny thing is, once you go over here, yours would be in Japanese. So how you get this to be in English, if you want to see it in English, is if you're using the Chrome browser, or let's say you're using a browser that supports extensions, you can this one, and I can select base model presets here. So I'm just clicking on this one and I can select base model, and this is the model without, you know, an outfit. So let's say you want to do a simulation, or you this one, and I can select base model. Which is www. How you can is pretty simple. All it does for you is gives you the ability to create your own digital anime avatar. So for example, you like to play with anime avatars, you love animes, but you want to create yours, this app would actually help you create yours. If you want to understand how you can get this out of here and maybe take it over to Maya or Blender and use it for your own 3D project, just sit right in while I explain. So for you to be able to get this app, or for you to be able to download this, you have to definitely go over to the website, which is www.studio.vroid.com. And when you go over here, funny thing is, once you go over here, yours would be in Japanese. So how you get this to be in English, if you want to see it in English, is if you're using the Chrome browser, or let's say you're using a browser that supports extensions, you can definitely install the Google Translate. So once you have Google Translate and you right click, you will be able to convert this from whatever language it is to English. And just reading this through English, it says if you create a character with the Vroid Studio, you can use this character as avatar for your VR and your AR. And for now, what we have here is that this app only exports .vrm extension. So .vrm extension simply means that you cannot use this for other platforms. But wait, I'm definitely going to show you how you can get this out of the studio and, you know, bring it over to Blender, and what you need to consider while you're bringing it over to Blender, the possibilities for you, and how you can get this out of Blender to something like Maya or maybe Motion Builder and all that stuff. So for you to download this app, what you need to do is you just simply scroll down here, go out to the download page, and it's definitely going to bring you over to this place where you see the Vroid Studio beta download, and you can go ahead and read out the entire thing. You can also see the previous versions. If you create a character with the Vroid, you can definitely come. And when you go over here, funny thing is, once you go over here, yours would be in Japanese. So how you get this to be in English, if you want to see it in English, means that down here, go out to the download page, explore this program and see what it looks like. So it simply means that there is no support for Linux at this point. So you can only access this if you're using a Windows or you're using a Macintosh, for example. And once you have this downloaded, you can just simply open it up. It's a free software, so it simply means that the installation might not be a problem. And how this works is, once you download this, it comes in as a zip file. So you extract the zip file, you double click, and you get it working for you. So let's just simply explore this program and see what it looks like, see the cool stuffs, the wrong stuffs, the things that we think that needs to be changed, things that should be updated, and then we'll go over from here and, you know, just talk about how we can get this out of the way and work with it. So if you come over to this part, there is something that just happened, and if you pay close attention, you'll find out that to each of these parts, there is a responsive or a camera that is responsible to this. So like I'm at the clothes editor. If I go back to the camera, you see that the camera switches back to either of these stuffs that I'm, you know, toggling through. So the first things first is for the eyes. We have the eyes, and you can see all of the controllers here. So in case you want to maybe narrow the eyes, you can make them narrower, and you can also come through and still texture the eyes the way you want to texture the eyes. So for example, let's say we have this face. Now I want to go ahead and texture the face. You can come through and, you know, you can start putting some paint. So let me go ahead and get a soft brush like this and pick up my pen, and let's just paint across this part. So if I come through and paint across this part with the pen, you can notice that we have more like a UV editor sort of style. You can see the entire UV very nicely done, and, you know, we can come through and start painting on top of this model. Okay, other things that we can do is we can also look at the mouth as well, and you can notice that we have stacked layers of things that we can access. Okay, so we have stacked layers of things that we can assess. If I close up the mouth and maybe come over to the part where I have like the eyebrow or maybe the iris, for example, and, you know, I come through and just select this, you can see that I have the eyebrow, and I can come through and, you know, start texturing that. And for existing hairs like this, say for example you want to come through and, you know, change the position of all of this, you can just simply come through, pick them, you know, and use the points to move them around. By selecting this, by selecting the control points, you can individually come through and manipulate all of these controls. And one other thing to notice is you can see how these things don't go way past. They don't go way past the hair cage. So looking at this now, we would also notice that just right around the corner where we have this design, we also have something else called bone. The bone is just like a representation of the bones that are controlling the hair. So these are individual bones. We cannot see them now, but these are individual bones that are selected as a group. Okay, I'm going to show you how you can find that later in the video. Then the next thing which we can look out for is textures for the hair. So we've selected the hair, we're within the hair category, and now you can see that we have a place where we can come through and also painting textures for the hair, just in case we have hair colors that we want our character to have, and let's say we're not comfortable or we are not just satisfied with the one we have here. If you go over to the body, which is also another interesting part of the entire program, we can customize the entire model. So for now, if I come over to the head, for example, and I want to change the head size, you would notice that the hair will also conform to it, because I can, you know, push the hair up, the head up and down. And you can also notice that the hair itself has dynamics that is interacting with the scale of the head. So once the head is going up and coming down, you can see that dynamics going up and down. And these are driven by joints or bones, depending on the app which you're coming from. You can also notice that we have this texture button here. So it simply means that you can go ahead and texture this and do whatever you want to do with it. Finally, we have one more before we talk about how you can export this, what you can do with it, and then, you know, what are the possibilities for this to work. One of the things I would say just before I go ahead talking about this stuff is I really wish there was a physical camera that you can place, but since there's no physical camera, we can do with what we have. As simple as it sounds, this part of the entire thing is where the main magic happens, okay? The other things are like building blocks to the magic that happens here. So let me just simply zoom out so that we can see all of this. First things you will notice is our character is blinking by default, which is really, really impressive. Okay, so let me just start all the way from the beginning so that we can see how all these things work. Cool. So here we have the face expression. The face expression simply works like this, just like your typical blend shape. That once you push the blend slider, you can see all of this blend shape happening. If you don't want the character to look at the camera at each point when you're moving the camera, you can simply turn this off. And it would not look at the camera. You see, it's looking at that point, but once you turn this on, you can see that the eye simply adjusts, and now it's looking directly at the camera. The next thing which we can do from here onwards is we can change the background color, which is something I particularly would not want to change, okay? And then we can come over to this part that would make you wow. So how do we work with this? These are sets of animation that have been pre-designed or pre-saved, or let's say pre-recorded for characters with this bone hierarchy. So once I click on standby, you can see that the animation happens. If I click on jump, you can see our character jumps, and of course you can see that the plot itself, you know, bounces along. If I come through and click on the other jump, and you see that happens. And speaking about the character moving, let's just go back and put in the default. If we come over to the cloth editor, we didn't talk about this. If we come over to the cloth editor, we have this cloth editor, and we basically have about three presets here. So I'm just clicking on this one, and I can select base model, and this is the model without, you know, an outfit. So let's say you want to do a simulation, or you want to simply do a retopology of something like this, or you want to just get the model out like this for some purposes, you can go ahead and use the base model and do whatever you want to do with it. And this one presently doesn't have any it doesn't have any outfit on it, it doesn't have any cloth. Okay, so then we can go to school uniform, and you can see the very basic manga styled anime look. And the next one we have is One Piece, which is exactly what we have. And now we have one last one, which is just pants. And now it's the same thing, but now it's more like a male kind of character with the character putting on the pants, okay? So you can choose from these to see the one that works for you. So I'm going to go back to the One Piece, and also you can increase and, you know, reduce this. For the cliff, you can, you know, play with these as well. All of these things are relative to the cloth which you are selecting for your model. So to different models, you have different cloths and, you know, different parameters to control them. Let's get back to the camera. So here where we have the camera, you can see we have different animations, okay? We have different animations. And then we have this other stuff that has to do with the pose. So for the pose, I'm just going to stop this animation for playing. So for the pose, if you come through and click here and switch to pose, you can see that we have a bone hierarchy that has an FK, that has an IK, sorry, that has an IK bind to it. So how do you know? Once you select this, you can see that we have this IK movement, you know, so now we can decide to pose our character like this. So at any point when you're done, you can simply, you know, just have this and capture this pose. So if you want to save out this pose, you can simply hit the capture and it's going to bring out the explorer, and from there you can go through and, you know.
El nuevo año ya está aquí. Es hora de desperdiciarlo con videojuegos. League of Legends. Descárgalo y juega ya. Wow, es como si fuera insertar festividad otra vez.
Ay no, ya terminé todos mis juegos.
Impresionante y triste. Rápido, antes de quedarte solo con tus pensamientos. Es hora de un nuevo juego.
Pero espera, no puedo comprar cosas.
Por favor, ¿gastar dinero? ¡Es el 2019! ¡Hablamos de League of Legends! ¡Es gratis! Y es el momento perfecto para jugar. ¿Sabías que LOL tiene temporadas? Como los deportes. ¿Y la Tierra? ¿Ha salido alguna vez? Ni te molestes. Nueva temporada significa actualizaciones. Con jugadores ocupados en los cambios y un flujo constante de principiantes, aprenderás en un campo de juego nivelado. Incluso hay un grado nuevo en el sistema de clasificatorias, uno más bajo que nunca. Ese es justo para ti. Te esperan horas infinitas de acción, espadas, magia, K-pop. ¡Wow! ¡Qué divertido! La vida real no es divertida, es triste. No estés triste. Mejor descarga el juego.
So I'm just going to save this as pose 01, and from there you can just simply maybe use it in any 2D texturing app or 2D application where you want it to be. So once you hit on capture, it's just going to, you know, make a screen capture of this. And if you're using the app, for example, and for some reason while you're using this, if I come over to the capture size, you're not getting a good resolution, you can also come here and change the quality of the resolution that you are making use of or that you want to export your file as. It has way up to 8K, so you can export as 8K. So for the post process, let's talk about the post process real quick. So for the post process, you can do some very amazing things here. The first one is the anti-aliasing. So we can go from very low to high, so it makes it a little bit more crispy. And other things is you can add a bloom effect as well. You can add the bloom effect, and you see all of those places where we have speculars. It's going to go through and, you know, just punching that bloom. And you can also do a bit of color grading to it. So let me just turn off the bloom and let's just shift the hue a little bit. And now you can see we're having a different color altogether. So you can simply play with these things and see how they work for you, if they are fine for your workflow. Then if you're okay with that, you can simply capture that as well. So let's just simply go back and, you know, reset this pose and have our character like this. And one thing to note is, even if you have an animation going on, when you export this out, the animation doesn't exist. Okay, that's a downside, which I think that the developers should take a good look at. Once you're exporting this, there is no animation. The animation doesn't export with it. That is one thing. Okay, so the next thing is you don't, or you cannot export to FBX, you cannot export to OBJ, you can only export to I think is VRM. Okay, so you can only export as VRM, which is the native file. And other file types that you can make use of, or which you can rename your file to, is the GLB and I think the GLP, and all of these are open source files. I'll put the links in the description, so just in case you want to read more about those open source files, you can go down there, you know, you can select on, you click on the link and read more about that. And so the big question is, how do you export this? How do you use this for production? Why would you want to get this out? Because you like it and you want to use it for your production. So how do you get it out? So if you come through and go over to this part where we have exports, you can choose to export as the original or shrinked texture size. So we want to export this as the original texture size. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're just going to come through. You can see how much materials we have. We have 18, we have 16 materials. And now another problem is it's going to go through and triangulate the entire thing. So you see when we're painting our textures that we had these chords or quads, depending on how you call it, but now we're going to have them as triangles. So what we do is just simply hit an export, you know, enter some details. So I'm just going to call these anime 01, and you can go through and put in all of the licensings that you want. So if you want to put in licensing for use and all of that stuff, you can go through and, you know, permit those things and select on OK. Another way you can get this out is you can simply, let's just save this. I'm just going to name this anime 01. Okay, so another way you can get this out is you can simply upload directly to the Vroid hub, and the Vroid hub is a cloud space where you can download models that other people have created, you know, play around with other people's model and also upload your own model. And all of these models that you find here, they are totally free, so you can just come through, look for them, download them and use them for whatever thing that you want to do. And how you can get access here is if you go over to the Pixiv, you can create an account at Pixiv, and from the Pixiv you can, you know, use the account here. You can see I have the same account here and I have the same account here. Now I have this object exported out. The next thing which I'm going to do is to, you know, bring out the model, and then we can go ahead and play with it. So this is the place where this model is exported out to. If I just simply do this, you can see I had one exported out earlier, and this is the pose model which we exported out just a few minutes ago. So what we can do now is I'm going to make a double copy just so I can explain something to you. If I rename this as GLB and say yes, I would be able to open this with the default Microsoft Paint, Microsoft 3D Builder and all that. But those things we're opening them as are just stuff that we cannot probably use to animate our character. So for us to be able to get this out so that we can use it for animation, we'll bring in the big guns and then we'll bring in Blender. So Blender is what we're going to use. For us to get this out, I'm going to come through to File, Import, and then I'm going to import the GLTF, which is the open source stuff which I talked about. So you can check the link in the description to learn more about this. And then I'm going to just simply click on this. I'll navigate to the part where I have this selected. I have it here, and I'm going to just simply double click so that I can get it to open. This file will take a while for it to open, and once it does, you would notice that automatically we're losing the blend shape. We're not having the joints or the armatures are not going to be there.
Tú y tu equipo tienen que hacer su trabajo. Con Monday.com es fácil, divertido y sencillo. Solo tienes que agregar.
But the model itself and the textures are also going to be retained. So from here, we can now decide to do whatever we want to do. Do a bit of housekeeping if you choose, and then maybe export it out. And there's something I noticed about exporting things out from Blender, especially if you're exporting an FBX file, which you want to use for apps like Maya and maybe 3D Studio Max. So for some reason, I don't know why, once you export, I'm using Blender 2.8. So once you're exporting your file out, or you're exporting as FBX from Blender to Maya or 3D Studio Max, for some reason it takes like a long time to load up, and even when it does, it loads up haphazardly. So the best way to get this or get your files out is you can simply export your files out as either Collada, which is .dae, or maybe as Alembic. So just like I said before, we had this file loaded, you can notice that we have all our bones laying before us. Okay, so they are all laying right on our feet. Okay, so what we can do now is, since we're not going to use this, we can just simply delete this. And another problem we have now is that the hair is on the floor, so we can choose to, you know, take the hair and position it where we want. Okay, so with our hair in place, we can now simply come through and turn the shading mode on. And now you can see what we have here. You can see that we're having the textures, but then we're having some form of distortion. So just before we jump into Maya and start looking at those stuff, there is just this thing about the texture that would be bothering you, or that it's presently bothering you. And that is because the normals of the main mesh itself is not proper. So if you look at it here, you find out that we have some normals that are not proper, and that's why we're having this distorted feel of the texture. So let's just go through and, you know, go over to the modifier panel. And within the modifier panel, I'm just going to select weighted normal. Okay, now you can see that normal is looking cool. You can do the same for here. And also the same for, I'm just going to close this because we don't need that anymore. And I'm also going to do the same for this as well. All right. And now, so you see, you can now play with this one and you know, go ahead, rig it, play with the textures the way you want it to be, and from there, you know, do all of those fun stuff that you probably have wanted to do long time. And just something that I would also like to put out there, if you want to use Maya and do something like this, I just went through and imported the file which we exported out from Blender. So let's look at how it looks in Maya. Once we bring it in, so I'm just going to simply drag in this Maya screen here. Okay, so once we bring this in, this is the file, which is the collider file that we exported from Blender. And for some reason, Blender doesn't really do a good job by exporting this. I think it's something that's still under review. Probably it's going to get better. But for now, this doesn't happen. Okay, so what you can do now is you can go through. You can see we still have the same normal issue here, we're missing textures here and missing textures here as well. This is how Blender exported it, and Maya cannot interpret the file properly. Okay, so what we can do now is we can come through, have a selection here, and go over to where we have mesh display. Okay, so we'll go to mesh display, we'll click on set to face. So it's going to set all the normals to the face. And you see we have this hard edges. We can now come through and say soften the edges, so the edges get softened. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm just going to come through and select set to that, and also soften the edges. And you see we automatically have that. The shoes for some reason is missing. I think this has to do with the textures as well. So if you do something like this, my big advice is you need to go ahead, and let me just go ahead and make a big selection and just simply come through and do that, and also soften the edges. Okay, so if you export something like this, my big advice is you need to go through and review all of these things one after the other. I may, depending on what you guys tell me, I may go ahead and get about one or two models like this and put it for free, so that if you want to play with this, and I'm going to do my best to simply clean it up and make sure that the textures are fine, clean it up and give it to you guys so that you guys can make use of it, play with it for your personal project and anything you want to do with it. I would like to know what you guys think about this in the comment section. And if you like this video, if you like this tool, I would like to know if you want to try it. Is it something you want to integrate into your pipeline? Is it something you want to try and see what it looks like? If it's something you support, depending on what you want to do. I would like to know what you guys think about this tool in the comment section below. And if you like this video, simply give it a like and share with your friends. And if you're new here, you can simply click on subscribe and also turn on the notification so that you get updates once I upload a new video. And until I see you guys next time with a tutorial review rant or maybe a news update, peace.
I love to dance now. I thought I sucked at dancing, didn't think I could dance, but for some reason I learned how to dance in Mexico. 'Cause because music sets the vibe. When Richie and I are about to film, we'll play a specific song or a playlist and just vibe out. We'll be dancing, we'll be grooving, and it gets us into that mindset to just create with freedom and with openness. My name is Cassie.
My name is Richie.
And we're part of the YouTube channel called To The Ninth. We do fashion, lifestyle, beauty, cinematography, you name it. My dad actually creates turntables. He would play like jazz music, Michael Jackson, Frank Sinatra, so definitely a lot of
Pero yo os contaré lo que he visto aquí durante este año. ¡Ah! ¡Es la guardia del puente! Silantius los engañó como a todos, pero la diferencia es que ellos tienen armas. ¡Corre! Ahí abajo hay una salida y un bote en el muelle.
¡También tenemos uno! ¡No es demasiado pequeño para los tres!
¡Es la guardia del puente! Silantius los engañó como a todos, pero la diferencia es que ellos tienen armas.
¡Corre!
Ahí abajo hay una salida. ¡Ve! Mientras yo podemos llegar solas al tren. Llevamos tiempo pensando en nuestra fuga. Incluso conseguimos un bote. Pero no teníamos a dónde ir hasta que has aparecido.
¡Ah! Y recoge al tío Crest en el puerto. Es muy bueno, sabe arreglar todo.
Llevamos tiempo pensando en nuestra fuga. Incluso conseguimos un bote. Pero no teníamos a dónde ir hasta que has aparecido.
¿Habéis encontrado al hereje, hermanos? Si Dios quiere, lo encontraremos. ¡Seguid buscando, hijos míos! ¡Está por aquí!
Ojalá pudiera pillar a un hereje. Pero no, aquí no hay nada.
Bueno, ¿qué has visto?
¿Lo habéis encontrado, mis santos guerreros? ¡Lo encontraremos! ¡No escapará a la ira del señor!
¿Estás durmiendo? ¿Acaso esperas que le monte guardia por ti o qué? Seducido por los herejes, hervirá en uno de ellos. Las mujeres en aceite y los hombres en azufre.
¡Sigue escondiendo, hereje! ¡Solo conseguirás que te coja por más papilla!
Muy bien, pues vamos a buscarlo. Cógelo por el rabo o por los cuernos cuando lo encuentres. Señor, protégeme.
Escucha, cerdo hereje. ¿Crees que te servirá de algo esconderte? ¡Ni hablar! Pronto sentirás la cólera de nuestro señor.
¡Eso contará a tu favor el día del juicio final!
¡El hereje está aquí!
¡Ay, hermano! ¡Satanás está aquí! ¡Detente esta columna!
¡Esta escalera! ¡Ahí está el maldito hereje!
¿Qué será eso que hay en la escalera?
Disponte a ser
¡Hey!
Juzgado,
¿quién es ese?
Porque grande será el castigo por tus pecados.
Ese lacayo de Satanás se ha escondido. Aún así, voy a encontrarlo. Voy a ir allí y voy... Sea el Beza, protector del pueblo. Oh, Beth, salva a los creyentes de la muerte y protégelos de la ira de hombres y bestias.
Thank you.
Salva y protege al santo sabio Silancius, el verdadero pastor de los fieles, pues solo él nos protege de la ira de Dios.
¿Eh? ¿El hereje? Bueno, pues pégame un tiro. ¡Vamos! Ojalá me hubieras matado. Mis hijos están muertos. Silancius no nos dejaba curarlos. Katia, esa antigua enfermera, dijo que podía ayudarlos, pero Silancius prefirió dejarlos morir lentamente. Vania sonreía cuando murió. Dijo que su hermana le estaba llamando, aunque ella ya llevaba muerta 2 días. ¡Esta vida es una mierda! ¡Pégame un tiro de una vez! ¡Venga, dispara, cabrón! Dicen que adoras al diablo. ¿Es cierto? ¿Me enseñarás? Yo sería un buen aprendiz. Muy, muy bueno. Venga, enséñame.
Sea el Pezar, protector del pueblo. Oh, Pez, salva a los creyentes de la muerte y protégelos de la ira de hombres y bestias. Alabado sea el Pezar, aquel que conduce las almas de los fieles hasta las puertas del cielo.
¡Artyom! ¡Por aquí! ¿Una ballena? ¡Es descomunal!
El viejo me envió como centinela de avanzada y me dijo que me quedara sentado y no actuara pasara lo que pasara. Así que me he limitado a observar desde primera fila. Y te he visto someter a las fuerzas de ocupación pacíficamente, con una cruz y plegarias. Ana ya ha informado de la secta. ¿Y si intercambiamos puestos? Odiaría volver a Moscú sin haber pegado un solo tiro. Estaba intentando quitarle la chica a un mercader. ¡Qué mala pata! ¿Por qué todos los demás tenéis misiones divertidas? El coronel te critica mucho, pero te da la mejor acción. ¿Es su manera de mostrarte afecto o es que quiere que te maten? Tengo que decir que es injusto. Me sacasteis de Moscú. ¿Y para qué? ¿Llenar la caldera y quedarme sentado con un estúpido catalejo? Aunque sí que tenemos la oportunidad de saquear algo. Está ese avión, pero déjame algo, porque creo que tendré que quedarme más tiempo. Aunque las gambas me están dando problemas. Ojalá pudiera convencer al Siluro para que se comiera todos esos picharracos. ¿Cómo lo haría Mowgli para hablar con los animales? Hablando de Mowgli, somos del mismo grupo sanguíneo, ¿no te habías fijado? Bueno, supongo que tienes que irte, Artyom. Ya noto a tu suegro clavando sus prismáticos en nosotros para convertirnos en estatuas de sal.
estúpido. Debería haber aterrizado en aquel campo, pero parecía que podíamos continuar volando durante un tiempo. Y entonces, esa maldita torre de alta tensión. Pero la verdad es que da igual. De todas formas, no vamos a llegar a Moscú desde aquí, eso seguro. A mí me importa un pepino porque estoy solo, pero los demás puede que tengan familia allí. Han pasado 10 años, pero podrían seguir vivos. En todo caso, ahora nos tendremos que acomodar aquí, ya que hemos sobrevivido. El puente parece un buen sitio. Al menos no se inundará. Más adelante puede que lleguemos a Moscú en tren. Bueno, habrá que vivir lo suficiente para comprobarlo. Tan estúpido. Debería haber aterrizado en aquel campo, pero parecía que podíamos continuar volando durante un tiempo. Y entonces, esa maldita torre de alta tensión. Pero la verdad es que da igual. De todas formas, no vamos a llegar a Moscú desde aquí, eso seguro. A mí me importa un pepino porque estoy solo, pero los demás puede que tengan familia allí. Han pasado 10 años, pero podrían seguir vivos. En todo caso, ahora nos tendremos que acomodar aquí, ya que hemos sobrevivido. El puente parece un buen sitio. Al menos no se inundará. Más adelante puede que lleguemos a Moscú en tren. Bueno, habrá que vivir lo suficiente para comprobarlo.
Thank you. este es el regreso de Artión desde el abismo de la ocupación de la OTAN.
Impresionante, después de los horrores que nos ha contado Luke. Vamos, papá está hablando con Katia ahora mismo. Son tan majas, tanto Katia como su hija. Y la formación médica de Katia no será muy útil.
Gracias por la información, Katia. Pero tengo que hacerte una pregunta más.
Por supuesto.
¿Qué sabes de las fuerzas de ocupación?
Lo siento, creo que no te entiendo.
¿Así que nunca has visto un ejército extranjero por la zona?
No, no he visto ningún ejército. Pero no hemos estado en sitios importantes, la verdad.
Comprendo. Artyom, un momento.
Artyom, ven a verme cuando hayas terminado de hablar con el viejo. Tengo algo para ti.
Has hecho un gran trabajo salvándolas, Artyom. Katia nos ha dado información vital. Un mecánico llamado Crest se esconde en el puerto. Necesitamos su ayuda si queremos arreglar la Aurora en un futuro previsible. Yermak no puede solo con las reparaciones. Así que cuando estés listo, ve al puerto, invita a Crest a unirse a nosotros y regresad lo antes posible. Tenemos que decidir qué hacemos con esos fanáticos del puente. Ahora sabemos a ciencia cierta que el puente funciona. Ellas lo cruzaron el año pasado para llegar aquí. Ahora las cosas están más claras, pero sigue habiendo muchas preguntas. Puede que no haya fuerzas enemigas por aquí. Es probable que solo vigilen las regiones importantes. En todo caso, lo sabremos de primera mano cuando lleguemos a Yamantau. El gobierno de Moscú es en esencia como un ayuntamiento, para que nos hagamos una idea. Así que solo debemos descubrir cómo cruzar el maldito puente.
Joder, no sé qué hacer con esto siquiera.
Deberías irte.
Podría cambiar el cilindro. Pero no tenemos uno de repuesto. Tendré que arreglar este. Y ni siquiera sé por dónde empezar. Normalmente se necesita un taller entero para arreglar cosas así. Bueno, ¿vas al puerto a buscar a ese mecánico? Haz cuanto puedas, por favor. Si no, ya nos podemos ir acostumbrando a este sitio.
Hola, Artyom.
Hola de nuevo, Artyom. Lo has hecho genial ahí fuera. Eso dicen. Mientras, nosotros defendiendo el fuerte. Hemos estado esperando a las fuerzas de ocupación, pero hasta ahora solo las hemos visto con alas o con cuatro patas. Nuestra ecología no les sienta nada bien. Y a algunos con pinta de bandidos a lo lejos también.
Bueno, Artyom, ¿vas al puerto? Allí no hay nadie, al menos no personas normales. Lo que sí que hay son mutantes, así que ve con cuidado.
¿Cuidado? ¿Artyom? ¿La perdición de los oscuros? ¡A por ellos, Artyom! ¡Más les vale que sepan correr!
¿Qué te ha parecido la mochila? ¿Es cómoda? ¿Puedes moverte sigilosamente?
Tengo un regalito para ti. Un fusil Tijar. ¿Te suena? Es neumático, pero pega fuerte igualmente. Además, hacer balas es pan comido, incluso sobre el terreno. Basta con que vigiles que no pierda presión. De lo contrario, las tendrías que escupir tú mismo. Por lo demás, nunca te fallará. Me ha quedado niquelado. Así que llévalo con honor. Y no olvides venir a verme de vez en cuando. Tengo algunas ideas para mejorarlo.
Gracias, Artyom. De no ser por ti, nunca habríamos escapado de allí. Estaban muy ocupados buscándote. Y Ana nos rescató.
Sí, tío Artyom, gracias. Tu esposa es genial. Es amable y muy fuerte. Gracias, tía Ana.
Ahí lo tienes, Artyom. Como siempre digo, has tenido mucha suerte conmigo.
Todos hemos tenido mucha suerte con Ana. Es una tiradora bestial. Ojalá tu madre hubiera podido venir con nosotros. Con una doctora de verdad seríamos imparables. Katia, Nastia, venid a por un poco de té. No seáis tímidas.
Gracias.
Bueno, Katia, ¿de dónde?
Artyom, ¿vas al puerto? Ahora tengo que relevar a Alyosha, así que no podré ir contigo. La mano le sigue dando problemas. Que Katia sea enfermera nos viene de perlas. Eso hará que sea más fácil convencer a papá de que las deje venir con nosotros. Hablaré de eso con él luego. Además, realmente no quiere abandonarlas aquí, lo sé. Pero está tan obsesionado con lo de esas fuerzas de ocupación que no puede pensar en otra cosa. Muy bien, vete a hacer lo que te ha mandado mi padre. Pero ten cuidado ahí fuera. Ya sabes que me preocupo por ti.
Rurales meridionales. Hace un par de años oímos que había un lugar estupendo junto al Volga, así que nos vinimos aquí. ¿Quién iba a imaginarse que lo controlan unos fanáticos? Y dicen que este lugar era un paraíso.
¿Viniste con tu marido?
Éramos 15, pero ahora solo quedamos Nastia y yo.
Lo siento. Hey, ¿a qué viene esa cara? ¿No te gusta el té?
Sí.
Oh, cuando la gárgola nos atacó, Nastia perdió su hocico. La bestia se lo llevó. Debió de pensar que estaba vivo.
Oh, no te preocupes. Encontraremos a tu hocico. Vaya, en Moscú los llamamos demonios y aquí las llamáis gárgolas.
Sí, me pregunto de dónde saldrán esas criaturas.
Bueno, es la radiación, las armas químicas y eso. La naturaleza se ha vuelto loca.
Sí, el planeta se ha ido al garete. No me extraña que Silantius tenga a todo el mundo dominado si la gente ve cosas así cada día. Pobres necios. Viven en la oscuridad y mueren de la misma forma, afectados por las enfermedades. Soy enfermera. Pero Silantius no quería ni oír hablar de que los curara. Decía que Dios se lleva a los suyos. Solo se preocupa de alimentar a ese pez con sus cuerpos cuando mueren. Dice que es la manera segura de entrar en el cielo. Intenté hacer algo para ayudarlos, pero no. Es pecado. Y entonces nos encerró en esa torre. Y no sé cómo, una estúpida linterna empeoró las cosas.
El tío Crest me dio esa linterna, pero Silantius se enfadó y la rompió.
Así es, y luego maldijo a Crest, y el pobre se tuvo que esconder en el puerto. Es una guarida de hombres bestia, así que Silantius no lo puede atrapar allí.
También quería obligar a mamá a casarse con él, pero ella no quería. ¡Es viejo y asqueroso!
Sí. El Evangelio del maldito pez no dice nada del matrimonio. Tuve suerte de poder proteger a mi hija. Ese pervertido es tan... ¿Nos sacaréis de aquí? Por favor.
Claro que lo haremos. No te preocupes.
Artyom, me he hecho algunas mediciones. Hay un punto altamente radioactivo entre nuestra ubicación y el puerto. Las lecturas se han disparado.
Será mejor que cojas un bote. Encontramos uno y lo hemos amarrado bajo el puente. Bueno, a menos que el monstruo te asuste. Duke nos lo ha contado por radio.
¿Miedo, Artyom? ¡Chorradas! Además, el monstruo solo es un siluro. Tras las bombas nucleares, la lluvia radioactiva fue a parar a los ríos y se sedimentó. Los siluros habitan en el fondo, así que se llevaron la peor parte. Por cierto, este no es tan terrible. He ido con cuidado y no me ha atacado. No creo que te ataque si no hace ruido. A fin de cuentas, no es un caimán. Por cierto, ¿tú has visto algún caimán? Cuando estabas en América, quiero decir.
No es que los hubiera por todas partes, como pasa en Rusia con los osos, ya sabes. Aunque una vez estuve en Florida y visité una granja de caimanes.
Aunque no he visto ni uno desde que me uní a los marines.
Oriente Medio, Moscú, la embajada, ya sabes.
Dicen que Miller te salvó de un linchamiento cuando las cosas se torcieron.
Sí, aunque preferiría no hablar de eso.